I'm Ben. You must be Jennifer?
Yes. But, Ben?
Ben Blake. Hey, it's a great place you got here. It reminds me of New England. Around Boston.
Is there someone down there with Jennifer, Roger?
Got no idea.
She's talking to someone. I can't quite make out who it is.
Probably one of the neighbors.
We haven't got any neighbors. Can you see who she's talking to? No, over there.
No, no, I'm afraid I can't tell. Not that it matters.
Well, I'm interested. As you should be.
Did you just hear a terrible roar? An aeroplane crashing?
No, nothing. Peaceful as a grave.
Oh.
Don't worry about it. Smile. There. We get a picnic tomorrow.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't think Mother would want that.
I think you could fix it. Tell her you have an admirer. Say he's flown in specially.
Well... Are you?
What, an admirer? Sure am. Fact is, I just can't wait for the roses to come out. So I brought you one along. Just to remind you.
That's lovely. Ben. Really lovely. Been a lovely day.
Lovely. Would have been even nicer if your mother had gone out.
Now, don't be grumpy.
Who is that you're waving to?
Oh, a friend. His name's Ben. He's a pilot. American.
Here we are. This will warm you up.
I'm quite warm enough, Mother. I'll wait until we eat this evening.
You know what the doctor said. You must keep up your strength.
I'm all right, Mother.
Very well, darling. We're only doing our best for you.
Yes, Mother. If you don't mind, I'd like to go up and rest for a while.
Well, of course I don't mind. Look, I'll bring you a cup of tea.
No. That's all right. By the way, I won't be in for lunch tomorrow.
You won't be in?
I'm meeting a friend.
Really? Are you sure you're up to that? I mean...
Quite sure, Mother.
Who's in the morning paper?
Roger. Jennifer's going out to lunch tomorrow. I said, Jennifer's going out to lunch tomorrow. With someone.
Yes, I know. With the American fellow.
Well, you know him?
Yes, of course. He's a pilot. Stationed at Billsborough.
Roger, this is the first day for 6 months that Jennifer has been out of the house. I think if she had an American airman for a friend, I'd be the first to know.
Well, obviously you aren't, are you, my dear?
Hi, dear.
Ben! Where did you come from?
Well, we're all set. This way, honey.
Honey. Do Americans really call people honey?
Hello, Jennifer!
Vicar, come in. A welcome surprise. And take your clips off. Take a few.
Thank you.
Last year's elderberry. I think it's come on rather nicely.
Ah. I have a rather delicate mission, Major.
Oh. Perhaps we should try the plum brandy.
No, no, no. This is quite sufficient. It's about Jennifer. I saw her taking a walk a few minutes ago. Is she quite recovered?
What's on your mind, John?
Well, she was talking to someone. I don't mean to herself the way we all do from time to time. I mean actually talking and reacting to someone.
Who wasn't there?
You know about it.
Well, no, not really. I saw something yesterday which didn't quite add up.
Do you think we should talk to her about it?
No, I don't want to startle her. The poor girl's had enough to cope with these past few months. I'll get the doctor in this evening. See what he has to say.
There we are. How are you feeling in yourself?
I'm fine.
But a bit tired. Headaches?
Not really, Doctor.
How about dizziness? Feeling a bit lightheaded?
No, not really.
She's not eating very well, Doctor.
Who is? Well, I think we ought to have her into hospital for a few days. Nothing to worry about, just a few tests.
Hospital? I'm fine.
It won't be for long. A couple of days, perhaps. I'll make the arrangements in the morning.
No. I can't go into hospital. Not yet.
Jennifer, if the doctor says you should...
I won't. You can't make me.
Do you have a reason, Jennifer?
Your mysterious American.
Ben has to go abroad in a few days, and we have things to talk about.
Now, don't be ridiculous, Jennifer. You hardly know the man. Your health is far more important.
I'm in love with him, and I think he feels the same.
Nonsense. I won't have you talking nonsense. We don't know who he is, what he's like.
Or even if he exists.
What is that supposed to mean? That I'm lying about him?
Now, Jennifer, your father didn't say that.
You won't stop me seeing him. You won't stop anything.
Jennifer, I just want to carry out a few tests.
What is it we won't stop, Jen?
I'm going to marry Ben.
Taken leave of your senses, girl?
You're not well enough to walk down the street, let alone up the aisle. Ben says I am.
I'd like to hear that from him.
You will. He's getting a special license tomorrow.
Now listen to me, my girl.
We'll hear what Ben has to say.
Tomorrow. That is a very good idea. This can all wait until tomorrow. Jennifer, as your doctor, my advice is for you to go to bed.
Thank you, Doctor. Good night.
Good night, darling. Good night. I had no idea what this was going on.
I shouldn't worry about it. It'll sort itself out.
I'll see you out, Doctor.
Good night, Mrs. Manley.
Good night.
Well, what do you think, Doctor?
I would like to have done some tests. She is far from well, Roger. Unfortunately, there isn't a great deal that we can do about it.
This virus she's got, are there any drugs?
None that we haven't tried. It is up to her now. Either she builds her own defenses
or... hallucination. Is that part of it?
It's not symptomatic, but the virus could be affecting the central nervous system.
What the devil are we going to do? She can't produce the man. He doesn't exist.
No. Perhaps that is the answer. Go along with the wedding.
What?
Until she's forced to admit to herself that it's all a fantasy.
I wonder. Yes.
All right. We'll do that. So we really have no alternative, John.
I can see your dilemma, Major.
Anyway, the whole point is that he won't turn up. He doesn't exist. There can be no wedding.
Yes, I see that. And Dr. Lawson agrees?
It is the only way that she will come to terms with her fantasy.
Very well. Shall we say tomorrow at 3?
Thank you, John.
I'll post the banns today and hope the bishop doesn't query it when he checks the register. I shall need the name of the groom.
Yes, of course. Blake. Benjamin Blake.
Benjamin Blake? You know, that has a familiar ring to it. Benjamin Blake. I'm sure I've heard that name before.
When you're with me, I am.
Well, I'll always be with you.
This American, Lieutenant Benjamin Blake, he's not quite a figment of your daughter's imagination.
You mean he exists?
I mean he did, up until April 1944. The name sounded familiar, so I looked him up in the church records. He was a fighter pilot returning from France. His plane had been badly damaged. He should have bailed out. But he saw the village below and tried to reach the fields. That's when he died, here in your paddock. That's where his aircraft crashed.
What are you saying? That he's a ghost?
I don't know. Could it be that Jennifer is psychic? That she really is seeing him?
No, no. Of course not. Anyway, phantom or fantasy, she'll soon come to her senses when he doesn't turn up tomorrow.
It's all right for some, of course.
You have a weary, self-indulgent look, Anne. I take it that you have triumphed over prudence and thrift. And that we're now teetering on the brink of poverty.
What a day.
You look tired.
But of course she's tired. She shouldn't be doing this sort of...
Please, Mother.
Take it easy.
Take it easy.
You'll never get through tomorrow, Jennifer. I think you should just call it off and wait until...
No. I'm all right. Really.
No strength, darling. You'll make yourself worse.
I will marry Ben tomorrow. If you try to stop me, we'll elope.
I don't want you hurt, my darling.
Then help me.
I don't see why he can't come back next month or the month after.
Because it's too far away. Don't you see? I can't feel it. Not next month. I can feel tomorrow.
All right, Jen. You go and get a good night's sleep. We'll get you to the church, even if I have to carry you.
Lovely, my dear.
Thank you.
Well, John, has the dragon arrived?
Father, you promised.
Your good lady, looking most delightful, if I may say so, is already inside the church with Dr. Lawson. I haven't had the pleasure of meeting your intended, Jennifer.
Oh, isn't he here?
Well, then, he's 5 minutes late.
He has a long way to come.
Well, then, let's take a pew. No point in your being on your feet too long.
I feel marvelous.
Good. Let's pray that this is a truly, truly perfect occasion. And that Lieutenant Blake lives up to his reputation.
Well, Father, of course he will.
Give him 5 minutes more.
He wouldn't dare that. I mean, after all we've done, taking him on trust like this.
Mother, don't worry. Ben won't let me down.
What's that supposed to mean, Roger?
Nothing.
Knowing look, if ever I saw one.
Jennifer, I really think we must tell you now.
Hi, folks. Hi, Chief. I'm sorry I'm late. For a while there, it was touch and go. I don't mind telling you.
Gathered together here in the sight of God and in the face of this congregation to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony.
I've got a photographer.
I've got a camera in the car. Why don't we grab him later?
It may not be properly chilled.
That's yours, Ben.
Thank you, sir.
But at least it's not elderberry.
Oh, that's a good look.
Thank you, Doc. Well, to the bride and groom.
Bride and groom.
Oh, no, the cake.
Must I?
Yeah. Anybody help?
Yes.
Okay, now, nice and easy. Yes. Yes. Oh. Don't even drink it. Now, let's try it again.
Where do we go from here?
I wish I knew. He's supposed to be going abroad in a couple of days.
I don't think Jennifer should go. I'm worried about her condition, Roger.
Well, they're leaving soon. They're spending the next 2 days on the coast.
I'll have a talk with them.
You realize I know virtually nothing about you.
Yeah, but you'd be surprised how much I know about you.
Oh, really?
Excuse me, Mrs. Cranley. Yes, could I have a brief word, then?
Sure, Doc.
Hello, darling. How are you feeling? You look lovely.
You know Jennifer is ill.
I know, Doc.
And you're going away.
We're both going away, Doc.
She's going to die, isn't she?
I'm afraid so, Doc.
Do you know when?
Tomorrow. Don't worry about it. There's nothing you can do. Or could have done. Time heals all wounds, Doc. Look, don't worry about Jen. I promise you she'll be all right. I'll be with her.
Yes. Well, I hope it's a surprise, sir.
Don't worry, Mom. We'll be fine.
Don't you think Ben ought to drive?
Oh, too much champagne.
Take care of her, Ben.
That's number one on my list, sir.
With her.